Welcome to DBSync, Cloud Replication for Salesforce. Why do you need replication? You can create a mirror copy of Salesforce on your local database. Create your data warehouse for business intelligence and reporting. Help some backup and archiving to comply to various IT and financial regulations, like SOX and FINRA. Easier to integrate various other in-house applications. Here you can see how DBSync can help create a schema of your Salesforce CRM on your on-premise database automatically with all the fields in Salesforce replicated in database. DBSync works on all platforms like Windows, Linux, or Unix, and it supports most popular databases like SQL Server, Oracle, etc. Let's move on to the product demonstration, and we will walk you through how Cloud Replication for Salesforce works through DBSync. This is the homepage of Cloud Replication. Here you can see there are two options, Global Setting and Manage Profiles. Global Setting. If you have any setting in the proxy connected to your network, you have to fill in all the details of the proxy setting in case you are behind a firewall. Manage Profiles would be where you can define your own replication profiles. You can have multiple profiles configured to Replication Salesforce and Database. I have Test Replication as one of the profiles which is configured in my system, which I'll pick for the demo. Now let's see how to set up. In Salesforce Details, you will need to point it to your Salesforce credentials, your username, and password. Select your environment, which can be either your sandbox or production. Once filled, you can test the connection and save the settings. Click on Next to fill in database details. In database details, you will need to provide database, username, and password, and select which database you would like to connect to. You need to fill in the database connection information and check by clicking Test the connection. So once the connection settings are saved, you can go to the next steps of selecting what to replicate. In Salesforce Sync Object, you will find all the Salesforce objects that you would like to replicate. Also, you can see all the available fields here. You can either select or exclude the field based on your criteria to replicate in the database. You can enter a filter criteria to further segment your data download. The tool provides you with capabilities to slice and dice what data you want to download from your Salesforce. Once set up, you now move to how you can monitor your replication. In Notification, you can assign an email address to get notifications of run completion. You can further enable database logging, along with the standard file logging which comes standard with the application. Advanced Settings provides special processing instructions around how to download non-replicable objects. You are ready to schedule it to run. Under Scheduler, you will find four processes. Clean Copy, which is a clean download of selected objects. Update Schema, which is like refreshing local schema based on what is in the Salesforce. Salesforce to Database, which is incremental update of data from Salesforce to Database. Database to Salesforce, which is uploading data from your database to Salesforce. You can run the scheduled job every 1 or 5 minutes depending on your business requirements. Under Salesforce Sync Object, I've selected Account, and I'll run all the four processes. Let me run the first process, which is an update database schema. Since DBSync is running on Tomcat, if you choose, you can see the updates and monitor the progress under the Tomcat console. You can see the process is completed. You can see the schema is created in the database, and you can see all the field information. Let me run the second process, that is clean copy from Salesforce to database. You can see the data is replicated. I will now run the third process, which is SF to DB incremental, and this would be on the basis of any changes that you make in Salesforce. Let me choose an account in Salesforce, and I'll change the phone number to 615-266-1234, and I will save this record. In the database, you can see the phone number, which is 111-111-1111. Now, if I go back to Salesforce, you can see the new phone number is 615-266-1234 in the SF account. Now, let me run the process. You can see the phone number has been changed to 615-266-1234 in the database. Let's run the fourth process. Now to update the data from database to SF, which is controlled by a flag. Here you can see the changes that have to be done in the database for this process. You see in the database the phone number here is 615-266-1192. Now I'll run the fourth update, which is DB to SF control by a flag. Now if I go back to SF and refresh the account, you can see the phone number is updated from the database. So these are the four processes: update database schema, SF to DB clean copy, SF to DB incremental flow, and DB to SF control by a flag. This was a quick walkthrough on how DBSync Cloud Replication works. Thank you all for watching the demonstration of DBSync Cloud Replication. You can follow us on various social media. To know more about DBSync, you can call us at 877-739-2818. Alternatively, drop us an email to sales@mydbsync.com. You can also visit our website, www.mydbsync.com, to register for a free trial.